Okay, so uChurch Hlophe respond to uRamaphosa and as well as uMalema respond to uRamaphosa. So I'm going to have to play you those videos. In this specific video, we'll be talking about that. But before we can proceed, it is quite interesting that uChurch Hlophe told uRamaphosa that when are you a liar when? The truth is not in you. What? This speech was written by DA. Uti, I suspect, Uti, this speech was not written by you. When you wrote the speech, or DA wrote, no, DA. I'm like, Judge Kaputi, aye. Lo, upalalo I DA lo speech. Lo, upalalo I DA lo. Muso name kuluma. Wait, you think I'm joking? We're going to get into this video. In fact, take a look at the video. Take a look at this video here.
If anything, it's the parties in the GNU. My guess is that it was prepared by DA members. I will tell you why I'm saying that. We were watching very closely in Parliament as the President was delivering his speech. It's the white members of the DA party who were busy applauding. So it was all about pleasing the GNU parties, particularly the DA.
But Dr. Hlophe, which parts were you not satisfied with? And as the MK party, what do you believe should have been included then if you're saying it's so appalling?
Okay, firstly, there is so much lies that is contained in the speech. I regard this president as a serious liar, a serious-minded liar. Firstly, he says his government, ANC, that we lead, has created more than 2 million jobs. We are South Africans, we know he's lying. That's not true. If anything, the rate of unemployment in this country is almost 35% now. So we have lost more jobs than we have created. That is a lie. The speech didn't address critical issues like the issue of Palestine. We know why he's not addressing that. It is because the DA is watching him in the GNU. He can't address it because the policies differ in respect of Palestine, right? So the speech was empty in that regard. Furthermore, the MK party, Umkhonto weSizwe, we have been very clear in terms of our election manifesto. We are for the return of the land to the rightful owners. We want Section 25 of the Constitution to be amended, right, in such a way that there is, in such a way that it makes provision for expropriation of land without compensation. We want nationalization of the key sectors of the economy, such as banks and mines.
All right, that's Dr.
Okay. So, Hlophe, after responding to that, we will need to go to Malema as well. Julius Malema also responded. I've got a lot of video here where I see Judge Hlophe, Malema. So we'll share a lot about you. Look, I will share a lot with you about this whole thing. Ramaphosa being told straight to good. When are your speech is written by DA. DA wrote your speech. It's not you. It's DA. We suspect. Where's that you look a show about GNU? What I guys, so this is hilarious, right? Created 2 million jobs. Guys, South Africa has been on a decline in terms of jobs. So which jobs did you create? Where did you create those jobs? Because maybe Ramaphosa is right to say he created jobs, but not in South Africa, because South Africa is on a decline. In fact, if you remember vividly, just prior to the elections, there was a stat that came out that talks about how many jobs were lost. Even as of now, Mercedes is retrenching about 700 people there. So When you say you created 2 million jobs, where are those 2 million jobs? Ramaphosa is just lying broad daylight. Like, but Ramaphosa is lying with a straight face. Ramaphosa is lying with a straight face. Yarr! And I mean, a woman, that guy is a liar. Yo, the truth is not in him. He doesn't abide in the truth. But in this YouTube channel, Tina, we abide in the truth because of this.
If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 Rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment, so the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, so let's proceed again. As we abide in the truth, we will now go to Malema. But before I go to Malema, Ramaphosa guys is a liar. That guy, like, tell me, what has the man done for this country? I created 2 million jobs where? Can you give us an evidence and show us what you know? When I say I created 2 million jobs, these are the jobs I'm talking about. Oh, man. The man is a liar. No. No, Ramaphosa has not made sure, guys. Ramaphosa has not made sure. That man is a liar. Take a look at what Julius Malema said about the man here.
You can see that is a wounded buffalo. We told you South Africa will eat this elephant piece by piece, and you saw it for yourself today. That confidence and that arrogance of February has gone through the window. And today, the man speaks like a man who has got no confidence and belief in what he's talking about. I won't be shocked tomorrow if I'm told that speech was written by Helen Zille, because the DA kept on clipping until the last full stop.
Oh, well, moving from Julius Malema, now we are going back to Judge Hlophe again. Don't worry. Stay with me in this YouTube channel because, wow, it's going to be late. It's going to be interesting. So what is of interest is this, that you've got this liar called Ramaphosa, right? He is going to create jobs. He is going to give this country prosperity. The problem that I have with all of those speeches is that, why didn't you do it before? Why didn't you succeed in it before? What is going to what is different now? What is it that you have now which you didn't have in the past 5 years? Well, it's a question that you and I should be asking. Not just to listen to these people lying to you. Yeah, we're going to create jobs. Judge Hlophe came back and said this.
Well, the speech was appalling to say the least. If anything is clear, the president did not write the speech himself. You can see there's a lot of GNU influence in the speech. It's a compromise speech. What I found even more appalling was the fact that he's justifying the existence of the GNU. We don't have any crisis in the country. The GNU came into existence because the ANC lost the election. Cyril Ramaphosa inherited an ANC which had 57% in the election prior to the last one. And then he brought the ANC down from 57% to 40%. So they lost the election. This was an attempt to remain in the office. And it has resulted in a bloated cabinet. The result is that he will never be able to deliver on the many promises that he's making. He knows he's lying. He knows he has not created more than 2 million jobs in this country. We are all South Africans. We know he is lying. I just don't know why he's lying with a straight face.
Speaking about Malema in this one, Malema came back. So we're about to talk about what Malema said. Responding to this liar, others are saying the scammer of not. This liar, oh, look, here's the thing. Load shedding, for instance. 2 months before elections, no load shedding. Few weeks after load shedding, no. They don't bring the actual load shedding. You know what they do now? They're like, hey, people will see that we are liars. Nah, let's not bring load shedding. Let's bring load reduction. Well, the other day, load reduction and load shedding, it's one and the same thing in essence, because all it has in common is that people don't have electricity. All that is happening under who? Under who? Malema responding to that, he said this.
They can go ahead. We don't have any kind of arrangement with the ActionSA or anyone of that sort. We don't have an arrangement with the ANC. We are saying to you, if the ANC comes and the DA wants to oppose them, we'll defend the ANC in Gauteng because of the stance they took. That was a brave stand. That was an act of defiance to this nonsensical neoliberal coalition led by the DA. This is not led by the ANC. Helen Zille is the crafter of everything that is happening here. So Gauteng said we are not going to be Matabaneka Helen Zille and therefore refuse that and will support them. Because that is a brave move. The ANC should have opted for minority government if it did not want to work with progressive forces. Instead, they decided to go in bed with reactionary forces who still have blood of our people on their hands.
Thank you very much.
All right. So we're moving from Malema. We're going back to Hlophe. All right. Don't worry. See, Singapore DJ is a mixer. Right. You know what I'm saying? We'll go back to Malema food. Oh, don't you dare running away. We still have a lot to talk about in this video. So we need you to watch the video until the end as we are busy with the liar. You know what I'm saying? We are busy destroying the lies. Do you think we will ever achieve that? Now, let me leave that. So we already see that load shedding wise, the man doesn't end load shedding. The man doesn't create jobs. But what is Ramaphosa creating? No, he creates a GNU. To those who doesn't know. A GNU where you bring Abo Groenewald, you bring Abo DA. I don't need to talk about their history. We all know their history. That is what Ramaphosa is good at. To say that Ramaphosa is going to advance the interest, your interest, no. That's a big mistake. Forget about it. Not Ramaphosa. Advancing your interest? Never. Never. Lingawa Tosho Inguku. Never forget. Well, Umalema, seeing what I saw, he responded to this liar, and said this.
President of the Republic?
Well, this was a state of waste of state resources because there was nothing new that the president had said. Actually, he's always coming with a new identity of his office. Just in February, we're at Tswalos. Today is a different thing altogether. It's very clear that the president has got no plan to transform South Africa for the better. Nothing about international relations, because that is a point of disagreement for this GNU. Nothing about the judiciary and nothing about the land. He can't concretely say this is the amount of hectares we are going to give to our people. A pure lie that he created 2 million jobs, which we have never seen as the people of South Africa. So he spoke to us in February. He comes, speaks to us on the same useless things that he's non-committal. If you look at that parliament today, the happiest people is white people in that parliament. The happiest people is the DA, because it's the biggest winner out of this GNU sellout government. President Ramaphosa has once more sold out South Africa like he did in 1994 when he did not attend Nelson Mandela's inauguration, which today he speaks very highly of him for opportunistic reasons. So we as the EFF are going to consolidate the progressive forces in this parliament and make sure that we hold this government accountable. We give this government just a year, and if it doesn't collapse within a year, it will not go beyond 2 years. We can guarantee South Africans a progressive government is coming in, which will transform the land, nationalize the banks, and ensure that there is enough jobs for all our people and fight poverty.
One of the key issues.
All right. The last one from the two. Now we have one last video from Hlophe, if I'm not mistaken, and one last video from Malema. So, Judge Hlophe, representing MK Party in Parliament as a chief whip, speaks vividly and he outlined certain things about this liar and said everything that he said. In fact, I agree with it. I don't even want to have to say it because you are about to listen to what the man said. I agree with it. Guys, if Ramaphosa is to change this country, he must change this country to certain, the change must be to such an extent that a person, a lay person there, they must appreciate, they must feel that there is a change, you know. One day I will unpack on how Ramaphosa destroyed economy in the hands of black people and make sure that black people are disarmed from an economical point of view. One day I will show you how he did that. He successfully achieved that task of disarming people, making sure that people are plunged into poverty. The same man today that says he's going to create jobs, the same man that is promising heavens and the earth to people, whereas, you know, he has plunged black people, back into poverty. And a lot of people did not notice that the impact of these things that Ramaphosa has been doing, how much impact it had on certain matters. But speaking about that, let's just listen to Hlophe here.
Reaction yakho after speech by the president. Uhulumeni wakhe udale imisebenzi more than 2 million. Siyayazi ukuthi ayikho lona. Singama South Africans, abantu bakithi abanamsebenzi bahleli phansi. Uqamba mama sidlale ngesikhathi sethu seza.
So kulezi zinto abayazichaza laphayana ucabanga ukuthi asiyilo qiniso?
Kusobala ukuthi le speech sakhe akayibhalelanga. Kwaloo nto ukuthi lapho uma ekhuluma ashayele izandla belungu, umfana wabelungu, thina sishayele izandla belungu. Kusobala ukuthi le nto beyisho lapha akayibhalelanga. Uqamba mama ubhuka bhenjani.
Uthini ngento beyisho nge-about infrastructure ngama-budget nani ukuthi izosebenza le nto?
Uyazelapha infrastructure? Yonke le minyaka bengayenzi ngani infrastructure? Bengayakhe ngani? Uyazelapha infrastructure? Can you spell the word infrastructure?
So the role, the role of the MK Party going forward in this parliament?
Thina asikho government of national unit. Asi-excite ama-blue lights. Sizosebenza. Abantu basivotele.
Okay. So then we have this challenge now. We've got this problem of crime in this country. The man is not responding, possibly. You know, I heard Floyd Chivambo, it's Malema or Floyd Chivambo, but somebody among the progressive forces was saying, I think it is Undlonze. They said, ever since the war started between Israel and Palestine, over 38,000 people were killed. In South Africa, where people are free, over 38,000 people were killed too. So it's like South Africa is at war in Gaza, look, judging from the numbers. With that being said, I want us to listen to Julius Malema addressing this issue as well and say, nah man, this liar, it's not me, it's Malema. Malema said this.
Of people who are going to initiate beneficiation in South Africa, because exporting is to the benefit of his masters, and therefore he will never support beneficiation in the country. He's just speaking about it because he has been president for the past 5 years, he has been deputy president for the past 10 years. Why hasn't he beneficiated in South Africa? Today, he's telling us about a solar plant that has given us 250 megawatts. But just recently, we have just received 800 megawatts from ESCO. And why is he not speaking about what our own state company is able to give us? But his state wants to promote the independent power producers at the expense of ESCOM. So you can see that the man that is not for the state, the man is for the private sector, the man is for multinational companies. But what makes me happy is that you can see that is a wounded buffalo. We told you South Africa will eat this elephant piece by piece, and you saw it for yourself today. That confidence and that arrogance of February has gone through the window. And today, the man speaks like a man who has got no confidence and belief in what he's talking about. I won't be shocked tomorrow if I'm told that that speech was written by Helen Zille, because the DA kept on clapping until the last full stop.
On the issue of the formation.
Now, wait here. So, maybe you were listening. Let me not start by me. Let me start by you. If you were listening to this, I want you to tell me something. Do you think that what Ramaphosa said yesterday, really, it is something that the man is going to do? If you think so, show me a proof that the Ramaphosa has changed. Because the Ramaphosa we experienced the past 5 years, that Ramaphosa has not done anything of substance or any valuable thing. That Ramaphosa has done nothing along that. So where do you get the audacity to believe that this time the same Ramaphosa is going to change? What do you think will bring the change? Right now, I'll give a practical example. Practical example. He lied with a straight face. 2 million jobs. 700 people are about to get retrenched. Anglo-American is about to retrench people too. I forgot the other third company that is about to retrench people. Let me tell you something, a story that you probably don't know. Prior to the elections, Anglo-American wanted to retrench people. Ramaphosa had to tell them not to do so. Wait until the elections are over, then retrench people. And then load shedding, right? They returned load shedding, but not necessarily strictly as load shedding. Now it comes as load reduction. Yes, certain areas are not affected, but some areas are affected. Where is the promises of Ramaphosa to look of equality? Because equality should also means that it should also means that everybody enjoys unlimited, because now they even call it unlimited electricity, right? Now, just after elections, you now suddenly the inequality is seen. So it worries me that you've got a person of Ramaphosa's caliber who promises people the world, look, heavens and the world, but delivers nothing. Even when he was inaugurated, he repeated the promises that he has made before, promises that were never fulfilled. But he was busy repeating all of those things, and people did not hold him accountable, and I don't know why.